So Alice is, of course, now super, super happy, but what about the others? So I suggest that we take a look at Dave here. And Dave, as you remember, he was working on a logistics problem. So what he was trying to solve was shortest tour. And actually, last time we left off, Dave wasn't too happy because we found out that it is not very easy to find a good search tree or a pre-processing strategy for his problem. On the other hand, of course, we also mentioned that in practice, shortest tour is usually very easy to solve. But from a theoretical perspective, maybe we're a bit lucky for Dave if we're not looking for the best possible solution, but accept an approximation. And then if we should find an approximation, Dave can get a little happier here. And of course, he doesn't have to be as jealous that Alice has such a nice NP-complete problem, and he seems to have a harder one. Now, lucky for Dave, there is a constant factor approximation algorithm for shortest tour. But since Dave is not that proficient in theoretical computer science, I think he doesn't really stand a chance of coming up with this algorithm himself. So you will have to pay close attention now to be able to explain it to Dave. The concept that we will use is that of a spanning tree. And if you've had an algorithms course before, you will know what a spanning tree is. But I'm quickly going to explain it to you just to make sure. A spanning tree is a part of a graph, or actually it's a selection of edges in a graph, so that the result looks like a tree. Well, what that means is that you select edges so that you still keep the whole graph connected, but you don't have any cycles. So a cycle would be something like this, where you can leave a vertex and then come back to it another way. So you select edges so that the whole graph is still connected, but there can be no cycles. So to have you figure this out, let's do a quick quiz here. This is the same network three times. And I'm going to give you three choices of what a spanning tree could be. And the red edges are always those that I'm selecting here. I would like you to tell me in which of these cases the red edges form a spanning tree for the graph.